A multi-million dollar revamp of Surry Hills Police Station has been unveiled. It's the same place that the new sobering up cells are, and that has raised new criticism about the so-called band-aid solutions to alcohol-related crime. Antoinette Latouf has the story.
It's safer, bigger and more high-tech. This is the new processing centre for Sydney criminals.
The demands in the city have grown and the demands of policing have grown, so too has this facility here.
Everything that we need as a modern law enforcement agency has come together in this one area and is there and available to our police.
The $2.4 million upgrade comes just weeks after drunk tanks were opened to take intoxicated people off the streets. But so far, only 40 people have used them.
Over 5 weeks, the numbers are reasonably low. We didn't expect that there would be big numbers.
So this isn't a case of just locking everybody up and throwing you in the cells for a few hours. There's an independent assessment. It's all video, it's all under video surveillance.
While the new measures to take crime and drunks off the streets is seen as a step in the right direction, they're also being criticised for being short-sighted and not getting to the heart of the problem.
We support any measure that reduces the impact of alcohol-related crime, but as we've said time and time again, it's time to stamp out drunken behaviour before it happens.
They're repeating calls for lockouts and 3 a.m. curfews to help tackle our binge drinking culture. Alcohol rehabilitation experts agree.
Putting people through criminal justice is a band-aid solution.
And they go one step further. They want more young people in rehab before they commit crimes.
That kind of diversion program is cheaper for the community and better for young people.
The Ted Noffs Foundation is lobbying for a nationwide rollout of rehab centres for teens as young as 13. Antoinette Latouf, 10 News.